Are you there, God? It's me, Margaret. In 1970, 11-year-old Margaret Simon returns to her New York City home. After spending her summer at a sleepaway camp, her parents, Barbara and Herb, inform her that the family is moving to a New Jersey suburb for her father's job. Margaret is dejected about the move, as she does not want to leave the city and resents being further away from Sylvia, her beloved paternal grandmother. She begins to communicate with God about her anxieties, thoughts, and hopes. Upon moving to New Jersey, she is quickly befriended by her neighbor and soon-to-be classmate Nancy Wheeler, who welcomes her into her friend group that includes two other girls, Gretchen Potter and Janie Loomis. At school, Margaret is given a year-long research assignment by her teacher, Mr. Benedict. When he learns she dislikes religious holidays, Margaret explains that since her mom is a Christian and her dad is Jewish, the family does not observe the holidays, and has left it up to Margaret to decide on her own religious identity as she grows older. Barbara is estranged from her devoutly Christian parents, Paul and Mary, because they disown her upon her marriage to Herb. As a result, Margaret has never met her maternal grandparents. Margaret's school assignment prods her to explore other religions and to ask her mom about her grandparents. She goes to different places of worship, including accompanying her grandmother Sylvia to temple, attending a Black Christian church service with Janie, and going to a nativity mass during Christmas with Nancy. Meanwhile, Barbara attempts to fit in with the PTA and signs up for multiple committees, which draws her away from her hobby of painting and teaching art. Margaret and her new friends anticipate the milestones of puberty, such as wearing a bra and getting their first kisses. Gretchen brings home a sex education book that they all look through, and the girls are shown a video about menstruation and female reproduction at school. The girls are most excited about starting their periods. Margaret becomes impatient when other girls get their periods before her, including Gretchen and Nancy, and she asks God to help her be normal like everyone else. She and Janie buy sanitary pads at a drugstore to be prepared. At a classmate's birthday party,